Jimmy Butler now 4 for 12 from the free throw line. Yeah, Florida State has showed some grit, and they have really dug in. And it's a two-point game, a chance for the lead with a three. Snare, little jump stop, couldn't get it to go. Loose ball, and the smallest guy in the court comes away with it. Bikes has it swatted, and it'll stay with Marquette.
With the mercy, he has given them some toughness, and he's allowed them to match down, particularly on the defensive end.
Well, he is their defensive stopper. They feature him as such, and he hasn't disappointed.
Under five to go in this one as DeMercy puts it on the floor. Can't get it to fall. Loose ball. Saved by Marquette.
Marquette still quick to the ball now, beating Florida State to the loose ball. But they haven't been able to capitalize over the last 7 minutes.
Johnson-Odom couldn't get it to go, but Hayward does. And Lazar Hayward with 15 to go along with 10 rebounds, the 16th double-double of his career.
And DeMercy's toast right now. He's dead.
Pitching the other way, answers.
That whole Florida State group. In fact, I think all 10 guys right now are gassed.
To take my coat off, you know? Trying to get cool.
Hayward has it stripped away.
You know, even when you're tied, I'm pushing right now. This ball is doing it.
Kept the ball under four to go. Jon Sciambi, Fran, Fraschilla, Lynn Elmore. The Old Spice Classic Championship game, part of Beast Week, presented by Lowe's. Shoreline jumper. Rolls around. 17 for Lazar Hayward.
You know, it's funny when you have a hard practice early in the year and the guys are fatigued, you put 4 minutes up on the clock, you say it's tie score, and then you see what they're made of. And this is a perfect example right here.
Pitching. Short with that shot. Tip goes Singleton underneath. 18 for Chris Singleton.
Murray's after a 5-8. He's got pitching shooting over. But from a fundamental standpoint, it's against the block out the shooter.
Tied at 50. Hayward, a three. Short. Alibi the rebound. And Florida State with a chance to take the lead.
Well, you got Kitchen and Singleton now. Singleton wants the basketball.
Alibi underneath. Butler to rebound. And Jimmy Butler at double-double, 12 and 10. Butler underneath. Couldn't get it to go. They slow it down. Florida State only lead in the game was 2-0. Alibi, jump hook, short.
And Alibi just can't finish. And he's got a gas Lazar Hayward trying to guard him. And you see Hayward slow to get back down. He's had to battle the big fella the last several possessions, but he's used his body nicely to push him just far enough out. And a jump hook doesn't make any sense.
Johnson, 17 for the junior college transfer.
Well, he rejected the screen. Everybody expected him to come middle, and he just blew by his man.
Again, Solomon Alibi with the decided height advantage. You see him rush to the corner, but the last couple of possessions, he's been pushed off the lane, and the jump hook is too far.
He's got 14 and Florida State leads.
That scoring after a timeout. It was set up by Singleton's penetration.
First time the Noles have led since it was 2-0 Florida State. Now where do you go?
Well, that's the interesting question because the big three are no longer here. But how about
Oh, my goodness. Morris after the smallest guy on the court picked a good time for his first 2 points.
And that's where you go if you're Marquette. because that's where they have their greatest success. Attack, attack, attack. If no one steps up to help, take it all away.
Pitching, looking for help, finds Laps. I'll be wrestling down low.
Now he's in the paint.
And he gets the jump hook to go. It's a little closer there.
Don't you like about this? If you're Florida State, there's no Tony Douglas. He's gone. He's with the Knicks. Who's going to be their go-to guys?
Able to make up for that. And I'm not so sure down the stretch, even in the NBA in the fourth quarter, that they would go 2-for-1. I want to be sure about this one.
Well, we have to run a little motion offense.
Hayward squares up, foul line jump. For Lazar Hayward.
That's a senior.
Kitchen calls timeout.
After timeout plays, out of bounds plays in the free throw game. This was after a timeout. Drew it up for his best player.
I'll tell you what, with Ivy on the free throw line at the high post, he's got to have some kind of screen down and the ability to turn back to the ball so he can get himself in position.
Almost a steal from Johnson-Odom. Kitchen gathers it in.
Screen across inside.
And he's too far off the lane.
And Florida State is on top.
I was going to say, too far off the lane to take the jump hook, but the quick turnaround jump shot.
As I talked to assistant coach Stan Jones, and he said one thing they were going to try to do to get Singleton and all of the open inside was cross screen. Take away some of the pressure and fight. Penetrate and kick or penetrate and go.
We're also worried about Lazar Hayward again at the free throw line. Setting screens, looking for the kick.
Freshman from Nigeria in.
Oh, a steal, a steal.
And he stepped on the baseline.
Wow.
Boy, was that close.
He'll guard the inbounder, Singleton. And he'll just chuck it deep. Hayward at the buzzer. Won't go in. Florida State is your winner. The Seminoles with a one.